Every New Year's Eve, we promise bravely to transform our lives. We become members of gyms and intend to get the shape we want. However, around February, we are the same gym shy as we were in December. What is the reason? Well, since we are not successful in execution. This is alike for firms as well. Being capable of transformation is the key to success for firms. However, transformation necessitates execution. How to do that? As we will see in the following, there are four disciplines you need to comply with to advance your execution and attain your purposes. When you master building these points in your firm, your most significant aims will be obvious and you will be successful in one of the most challenging things, altering people's attitudes. In this book review, we will discuss how whirlwinds make you attain your aims, the reasons for fuzzy goals will not make you to the moon and back, and the reasons for you to have a scoreboard in the office. Chapter 1 Transforming People is the real hardship of executing strategic aims. Transformations are nice, specifically from a business viewpoint. The reasons? Because if you are not constantly getting better, you are creating an opportunity for your competitors to step in. Avoiding from is a big difficulty. And the reasons are, although there are lots of potential growth strategies, there are just two methods for the execution of these strategies, with a scratch of a pen or by altering people's attitudes. Certainly, stroke of the pen activities are simple for executives. They just sign a paper and leave the work to others. However, these are often quick fix activities. Permanent transformation, however, necessitates people to change their attitude. This is the reason why the majority of the executives lack nothing unexpected. Anybody who ever quit smoking or followed a dietary plan will come across, transformations are challenging. And these instances are just about transforming yourself. Transforming others is even more challenging. Your employees may not grasp the firm's aim or have a sharp perception of how transforming their attitudes would assist in attaining the aim. Or else, they just do not care. When you look at it first, it may look like you can solve these issues in simple ways. You would just elaborate firm aims to a paper, be exact about the responsibilities of each individual, and expel anybody who does not care. However, the main issue is much more complicated. All of these issues are named the whirlwind. Authors utilize this word to explain the everyday tasks that consume your time and dry up creative energy. The whirlwind is the greatest enemy of transformation. Think spending an hour convincing someone to transform something and at the same time, they have 10 critical things that need to be tackled immediately in their heads. Even though it is hard, you can attain key strategic aims regardless of the whirlwind. By learning the four disciplines of execution, it will become simple to you. We will learn about those in the following lines. Chapter 2 Concentrating on definite, critically significant aims is the first discipline of execution. The first discipline of execution, concentrate only on the things that matter. Of course, there is an instinct to work for doing more. The majority of executives are overachievers and because of that, they are especially motivated to work for doing more. However, the more you work to do, the less you can concentrate on and work on personal tasks. If you would like to be successful in something special, you must focus on it. Therefore, your strategy needs to put first one or two wildly important goals, WIGs, that you can follow even though there is a whirlwind. Reducing costs by 20% by the year end may be a sample to a WIG, however, there is a way to produce these goals. WIGs need to be exact and influence group efficiency enormously. Specificity is very important since a WIG should not be considered as a vision or a mission statement. Instead, it means defining an explicit aim that everyone will try to achieve. To grasp the reasons for specificity to be strong, listen to this tale. NASA, in 1958, defined its purpose vaguely as enhancing human knowledge of phenomena in the atmosphere and space. However, in 1961, that was altered when President John F. Kennedy publicly invited the organization to send a man to the moon and bring him back securely to Earth before the decade ends. This was an example of how a definite aim and date enabled Neil Armstrong to go to the moon on July 21, 1969. The NASA case shows us that defining an impactful WIG is of utmost importance. Nobody would like to waste blood, sweat, and tears on things that do not transform things in your firm. Chapter 3: The second discipline of execution is achieving your aims by selecting measures that mirror today's attitude. We read in the previous chapter that we need to concentrate on attaining wildly crucial aims. To make it happen, we need to focus on measures that will assist us to victory, not measures that make us pessimistic when we cannot fulfill them. This is simpler to utter than make because the majority of people often concentrate on lag measures. The lag measures mirror past performance and demonstrate our place compared to our aim. Profit margins and customer satisfaction rankings exemplify them. Even though focusing on these measures is inherent, it does not completely allow us to attain our aim. The thing is, these measures mirror past occasions we cannot transform anymore, which is the reason why observing them is discouraging for us. For example, imagine you want to get slimmer. Not weighing yourself and evaluating the result until the end of the month is not a super idea. You would feel bad if you do not reach your aim. Furthermore, at that time, you would be late to take action. This is the reason why you need to concentrate rather on lead measures to attain your wildly crucial aims. Opposite to the lag measures, lead measures mirror today's attitudes, therefore, you will have time to have an impact on them to attain your aim. In the getting slimmer case, calorie and exercise measurements would be very good lead measures because they are useful in forecasting the getting slimmer aim. If you observe your dietary plan and exercise, possibly, you will get slimmer. These are the two elements you can govern. Everybody knows that the way to get slimmer includes fewer fast food and more movement. However, acknowledging and acting are different from each other. You would be more likely to pursue your aim when you measure and observe lead measures because these measures demonstrate whether your actions are useful for your aim or not. Chapter 4: Inspire your group by saving scores on their performance, which is the third discipline of execution. According to the initial two disciplines, we determined our wildly important goal and which measures will play a role in attaining it. The third discipline is assisting your personnel associate with the aim, therefore, inspiring them to attain it. Regarding, you need to save scores of group member performances. Doing this would make performance better since everybody likes victory. People are also attracted right away when there is something to win. Therefore, saving scores is a method to attain that serious energy and determination. For example, when you look at children playing football outside, you possibly can immediately understand they are counting scores. How they cheer with touchdowns is enough to tell. This is the reason for your group to build a scoreboard, counting every member's progression towards the wildly important goal. No matter if it is a modern digital application or an old-fashioned chalkboard, the purpose is to demonstrate to everybody their performance. You need to make certain that your scoreboard is understandable and simple for group members to handle by themselves because the purpose of the scoreboard is motivation. You should also put lead and lag measures on the scoreboard in addition to the requisite information about the aspired position and the current position of the group. When all these are placed, every group member needs to be able to understand whether they are going to a victory or a failure. Imagine that a wildly important goal of yours is rising production by 20% by the year end. To attain that aim, your group needs to raise production by 5% monthly. The scoreboard has to demonstrate lag and lead measures linked to this particular aim so that your group would grasp their real performance. Chapter 5: The fourth discipline of execution is developing a culture of accountability. In the third discipline, we studied the ways to inspire employees to associate with your wildly important goals. However, the fourth discipline is the most important one for the process of execution. It is taking people to sustained commitment to the aim. To achieve this, your staff should be accountable to each other. Being accountable just to you is not enough. Nobody would like to let their counterparts down, so employees would obtain more feeling of responsibility if they should respond to their peers as well. This is the reason why meeting for WIGs will enable a sustained commitment to the aims. These meetings should involve, 1, a summary of the commitments made the previous week, 2, an evaluation of the scorecard, and 3, a scheme for next week. These gatherings will ensure stable advancement toward the WIG because every group member will be responsible for developing and satisfying weekly commitments that will influence the lead measures. It is significant to let employees select their commitments themselves so that they would be connected with the process. As the leader of the group, your job is to make certain that commitments are precise and directly attached to the WIG. Town Park, a valet parking services firm, perfectly exemplifies the way this functions. When they followed the four disciplines method, group leaders determined the WIG of raising the satisfaction of customers. Regarding this, they defined decreasing retrieval time, in other words, the time spent for the valet to hand over a car after a customer calls for it, as a significant lead measure. By concentrating on this measure, the valets found out an original way. When they expected a customer would call soon, they would turn the cars forward from the back of the parking lot. All thanks to the four disciplines. However, it is not that easy. It requires real work and commitment to apply them in the workplace. Continue to understand more. Chapter 6: To apply WIGs and decide on beneficial predictive measures, pursue a step-by-step procedure. Placing the four disciplines in the workplace might be challenging at the beginning, however, it is worthwhile. To place the first discipline, determining a WIG, only pursue the four simple steps. The first step is to collect lots of ideas. Discuss with leaders and employees to be sure that you have reached a big amount of information that would be sufficient. The second step is rating these ideas according to the influence they would make on the WIG in general. For instance, a major hotel chain determined their wildly important goal as rising total profit from $54 to $62 million by the year end. Their secondary wildly important goal was determined as reinforcing the unification of its restaurants, local sports, and cultural venues. They discovered that this would bring more customers to the restaurant and hotel, eventually assisting them in attaining their profit aims. The third step is to examine your ideas to be certain that they are parallel to your WIG in general. The restaurant in the case above could have erroneously determined their secondary WIG as enhancing their restaurant menu, however, that would not help them increase profits. That is why examining your WIGs is very significant. Finally, determine an easy and sharp description of your aim. Preferably, you would start with a verb and continue by determining the lag measure, a deliverable, and a finishing date. For example, decrease a verb manufacturing costs, a lag measure, from $20 to $15 million, a deliverable, by the 31st of December, a finishing date. You can pursue these identical steps to choose your lead measures, so you can also apply the second discipline. Always re-measuring and examining the lead measures is specifically beneficial, so being certain that they are predictive, certain, and assessable. Chapter 7: Keep presenting a scoreboard and developing a cycle of accountability. As we learned above, we can pursue some basic steps to place the first and the second disciplines. You cannot place the third and the fourth disciplines with such a systematic tidiness, however, somehow a plan is needed. Begin with the third discipline. Creating a scoreboard necessitates less participation of you than the other steps. You just need to find the preliminary theme, a speed indicator, a graph, or something completely different. Afterward, leave the scoreboard to the group for designing and developing it. In this way, they will perceive that they are attached to the process more. Do not forget to state to them that a great scoreboard needs to have only the vital information, the aim and the lead and lag measures. When the board is ready, assign somebody to make it up to date regularly. Now, let's move on to the fourth discipline. Placing a culture of accountability necessitates you to tone an example for your group. This is a significant step. The fourth discipline is the most important one for execution, but a challenging one as well since it necessitates real commitment and devotion. Recall, when you determine a weekly meeting, you need to participate every time. Begin the meeting by notifying staffers about your commitments, to demonstrate that there is nothing to fear of. Afterward, make certain to look at and talk about the scoreboard and congratulate every achievement. Do not forget that the whirlwind is not the topic of the WIG meeting. Make certain that you will only talk about WIGs. All group members who fail to satisfy their WIG commitments due to the whirlwind should be held accountable. When they fail to satisfy a commitment, you need to go about it with respect. Make the employee know that you care about their work, however, tell them that it is very important for the entire group to pursue their WIG commitments. Give them another opportunity to pull up with their commitment. Chapter 8 to include all groups in the four disciplines model, pursue a six-step process. If you desire to apply the four disciplines at a big company with 10-plus distinct departments, be certain that you plan meticulously. This process requires six steps. The first step is sharply determining your general primary wildly important goal. The second step is to include the group leaders. Every department leader needs to identify a wildly important goal and convenient measures that suits the general WIG. As the corporation head, you can reject some goals that look unsuitable with the corporation's aims in general. However, be certain that every leader is free to select their wildly important goals. Else, you cannot achieve the level of participation you seek for. In the third step, you meet with the group leaders to make sure that they learned well about the four disciplines model. You need to do it for them to apply this method in their departments. Fourthly, every group leader proceeds and starts the process in their group. They need to take feedback and be sure that the department accepts continuing on the WIGs and lead measures. Fifthly, every group works on improving the method. Preferably, department leaders need to get further mentoring on the process for a minimum of 3 months. Finally, conclude everything by putting quarterly meetings with every group head to talk about the advancement achieved together as a corporation. Yes, that is it. You have applied a process that enables you to attain your aims and execute your vision. The four disciplines of execution, achieving your wildly important goals by Chris McChesney, Sean Covey, Jim Huling book review Executing Strategic Aims necessitates transforming people's attitudes in the middle of a whirlwind of pressing everyday tasks. However, heads of firms need to concentrate on only one or two strategic aims and beneficial main measures to execute their vision all over the corporation. Select an aim that will make a real influence on your performance. There are two sources while selecting a wildly important goal, everything inside the whirlwind and everything outside the whirlwind. A wildly important goal that is chosen from the whirlwind can be things that should be fixed urgently or things your team is already good at and requires to utilize as leverage. Outside the whirlwind, you generally select from things that allow you to obtain a strategic advantage, such as adding new product features.